Assalamualaikum friends. In this video we are going to discuss about the fastening feature. Fastening feature is nothing but it is placing default structure in a required face. There are first three types of fastening feature here. In this video we are going to discuss about these three types: mounting boss, snap hook and snap hook groove. First we have to open a new file part. And click OK. First we have to create a base solid component for applying this fastening feature. So go to the sketch, draw the circle and click OK. Exit the sketch, go to the features, select extrude boss or base with corresponding to our sketch and specify the amount of thickness to be added here. And then click OK. After that we are going to use a first type of fastening features, such as a mounting boss. Let's move on software, go to the insert, select a fastening feature. Inside theme we have to select a mounting boss. After selecting a mounting boss, the dialog boxes appear. We have to select a face where we want to place a mounting boss structure. Now the structure is added here. You can also change the direction of the structure as per your requirement. Likewise, you have to change the type of structure as per your requirement, such as a hard burner boss or pin boss. You can also customize the dimension of mounting boss as per your requirement. You can change the all dimensions based upon your wish. You can also increase the number of wings. You can change the dimension of all wings. It looks like a fin structure. Then click OK. Now the mounting boss is created in a corresponding place. You can apply the different color for a good appearance of mounting boss. After that we are going to use a second type of fastening feature. So before that we need to create a base part for applying the second type of fastening feature. Draw the rectangle, exit the sketch, go to the features, select extrude boss or base with corresponding to a rectangle. Give the amount of thickness to be added here. After that we have to make a shell for this rectangle. So go to the shell option, select a corresponding face to be open and give the amount of shell thickness as per your requirement. Then click OK. While the shell cannot be created, you have to change the amount of shell thickness. Now the shell is successfully creating. Okay. Now I am going to apply the fastening feature, such as here snap hook. We have to make a different color for the shell. Before that, snap hook is here. Default structure like a hook we have to create at required dimensions in a required space. The snap hook groove is similar to the snap hook, but it removes the material. Next, we are go for insert and select a fastening feature. Inside the fastening feature, we have to select a snap hook option. Select a snap hook. The dialog box is appears. In a first tab, we have to select the location of hook where we want to position it. So select a corresponding any one of the face in a rectangular box. In second tab, we have to specify the vertical direction of the hook. I am going to select the vertical edge of the shell box to specify the direction of hook. In a third tab, we have to define the direction of facing the hook. I am just select the any one of the face of rectangle for hook direction. Now the hook is created here. You can also change the dimension of hook by customizing it. Just change the dimension of hook as per your requirement. Specify the parameters dimension within a snap hook data to change the dimension of hook. After that, you have to just click OK. The snap hook is generated here. Next, we are going to see the further type of fastening feature, such as a snap hook groove. Let's move on software. First, we have to open a new file part. Then click OK. Select a plane which you want to sketch and make it to the normal view. Go to the sketch, select a rectangle and draw the rectangle here. Then click OK, exit the sketch, go to the features and select extrude boss or base with corresponding to our sketch and specify the amount of thickness and click OK. For applying the snap hook groove, we need to create a snap hook first. So go to the insert, select a fastening feature and select a snap hook from the option. Then we have to specify the face and vertical direction and facing direction of the snap hook. You can change the reverse direction for appearance of snap hook. Just click OK. Now the snap hook is created. By using this snap hook, we are going to create a snap hook groove. We have to make a just different color of snap hook for good appearance. Then click OK. Now the hook is created. By using this, we have to apply the snap hook groove option. Now I am going to mirror the rectangular solid bar for applying the fastening feature. Now the snap hook is hidden here. So let's move on the further display style. Then go to the insert with corresponding fastening feature and select a snap hook groove option. After selecting a snap hook groove option, the dialog box is appears here. In a first tab, we have to select a snap hook which we create previously. In a design tree, we have to select this option. In a second tab, we need to select a solid where we need to create a snap hook groove. I am going to create a snap hook groove in a boss extrude. I'm just select a extrude boss here. Otherwise, you can select a workspace component. You can try again. Go to the snap hook groove option. select a snap hook in a first tab. In a second tab, we need to select a solid bore, then click OK. Now the snap hook groove is successfully created. You can check by changing the display style. Now the snap hook groove is appearance here. Then you have to check by using the cross section view. You can create a plane in between the groove. After that, we have to change the display style and select a sectional view option in your view manager tab. Now the groove is created. This is a major use of snap hook groove option. By using the groove, we create a cut in a solid material. So further type of the fastening features we are going to discuss in next video.